Hi, my name is Julia Lambeth. I'm an educator at WSET School London, and in this video we're going to look at five options for white wine making. So first we're going to talk about skin contact. Here we're talking about leaving the skins and juice of the white grapes in contact for a short period at a cool temperature before fermentation starts. This can also be known as cold maceration. The purpose of this would be to extract some more flavour and more texture from the skins of the grapes. It's commonly an option used for aromatic white grape varieties such as Riesling. It would generally be used for grapes where the aim is to make a quite high quality wine, because it is a process that's going to add more to the time of production and therefore more to the cost of production as well. Option number two would be looking at the different choices with regards to fermentation. So we know that fermentation has to happen when we want to make a wine. However, there are several choices here with regards to what we can do as part of that fermentation. So the first option could be the vessel. Here we could be thinking about using stainless steel as the vessel. Stainless steel is inert and therefore will not add any flavours to the wine. We could also consider using oak as the vessel. Oak can add different flavours to the wine as the wine fermentation progresses. Or we could use a bit of both, use a stainless steel vessel with some oak inserts. Oak barrels can be quite expensive, so using oak inserts can be a way to get some of the flavour of oak without the cost. Another option will be the temperature of the fermentation. White wine fermentation temperatures are generally between 12 and 22 degrees Celsius. This will be a little bit cooler than red wine fermentations. And this is because in white wines, we want to preserve the fruity character of the grape varieties, which could start to evaporate if the fermentation temperature became too warm. Sometimes winemakers can try and control the temperature by using cooling or heating methods, particularly if they're looking at stainless steel fermentation vessels. Another option is yeast. Which sort of yeast to use? Broadly, we split the choices into ambient yeast, which can also be known as wild yeast, or we can use cultured or inoculated yeast. Some winemakers prefer wild yeast because it can add more complexity to the wine. Others might prefer the inoculated yeast because this can give you more of a predictable, controlled result. And then the final option can be when to stop the fermentation. We know that with some white wines, they can have a little bit of sugar in them. And one way to control this is to stop the fermentation by chilling the wine and then removing the yeast afterwards. Another option for white wines is malolactic conversion. This is also known as malolactic fermentation. So here we are looking at changing the malic acid in the wine, which can be quite a harsh green acid, into lactic acid, which is a softer acid. And it can also give us flavours such as cream or butter in the wine. This is a process done by bacteria, lactic acid bacteria. And so again, it's the option of the winemaker whether they want this to happen or not. If they want it to happen, they can keep the wine at an ambient temperature, keep it free from sulfur dioxide, and they can either add the bacteria or, again, let the wild bacteria do the work for them. If they don't want it to happen, then they would do the opposite. They would keep the wine chilled, and then they would use some sulfur dioxide, which is an antibacterial agent, to prevent the malolactic conversion from taking place. There are certain styles of wine where we generally expect or might see some malolactic conversion. For example, Chardonnay is a grape variety where it's often suited to having those buttery, creamy flavours. Other grape varieties like Riesling, we might decide not to because we want to preserve those delicate aromatic characteristics of the grape variety. Lees contact is another option we consider here. So the lees is the name we give to the sediment that's formed by the dead yeast cells and other particles at the end of fermentation. Over time, these can fall to the bottom of the vessel, and we'd actually divide them into two parts, the gross lees and the fine lees. The gross lees are the bigger particles, And these would generally be removed after fermentation because they can add some undesirable flavours. So then it's the winemaker choice as to whether to keep the fine lees in contact with the wine. If we do keep the fine lees, they can again add flavours to the wine, such as biscuit, brioche, toast, and they can also add more to the body, to the texture of the wine. How long the winemaker keeps the wine in contact with the lees for will be an option. The longer the amount of time, the more of those flavours we're going to get. You can also see some winemakers choose to stir the lees up to get more flavour as well. It should be noticed that keeping the lees in contact with the wine is a choice independent of the vessel. So some winemakers will do this in stainless steel vessels, some winemakers will do it in oak vessels. They are separate choices. And then the final option is oak maturation. So when we're talking about oak, we are again talking about many different choices. This can include the type of wood. So here we can split the different types of wood broadly into American oak or European oak, and these will impart different flavours to the wine. Generally, European oak is more expensive, but is considered finer. So depending on the style of wine that you're making or the cost of wine that you're making, that could influence which type of oak that you're looking to use. The size of the barrel will have an impact as well. The smaller the barrel is, the more surface area of wine that is in contact with the wood. So we're going to get more flavour from using smaller barrels and then less flavour from using larger barrels. We can also consider the production of the barrel as well. When barrels are being made to turn them into those lovely curved shapes that we know, the wooden staves have to be heated. And while they're being heated, they can be toasted. And the winemaker can order the barrel in a light, medium, or heavy toast. The more toasted the barrel is, the more we're going to get those smoky, toasty flavours in the wine. The age of the barrel will also make a difference. The first time a barrel is used, the more flavour it will impart. Each time a barrel is used subsequently, it will add less and less flavour, and eventually it will have no flavours left to add to the wine. Barrels that are old can still be used for their oxidative influence. Another thing to consider about older barrels is that they can build up a layer of tartrate crystals, and this can act as a physical barrier between the wine and the wood, again meaning that the wine would not be extracting much flavour. And finally, we can think about alternatives to barrels. Here we're talking about oak staves or oak chips. These are cheaper than oak barrels and can still add oak flavours to the wine. However, they will not have the same oxidative effect as wines that are aged in barrels will. And then finally, we can end with an example exam question. So here the question is, explain why large, old oak barrels would not have much influence on the aroma and flavour of a wine for 4 marks. So just to look at this question first, here the command verb is explain. So here we want to be able to connect the different pieces of information to the result. And in the question, we've specifically been told that it's old oak barrels. So here our answer could include information like, old oak barrels have been used several times before, meaning that they would have lost their flavour. Large barrels have a smaller amount of wine in contact with wood, which means that the wine would not extract much flavour. Also, a layer of tartrate crystals can build up over repeated use, which would stop the wine from coming into contact with the wood. That's everything for this video. Thanks for watching.